definitely that, that Luke and I are soulmates. They're connected in a certain way that's too hard to explain through words. What I think Lucky has learned from his dad, from Luke, about love, is being and protecting. Protecting who he loves. Never backing down to the people that he loves. And Luke has just shown that in every way. And he'll do anything for his kid, for his wife, for anybody he loves. He'll go out of his way and put his life on the line. From his mom, I think he's learned more of a tenderness, more of a softness. And I think if he puts the bounds together, it can be a very powerful thing.
I really like to name my daughter after my mother.
Could
hang a picture of
grandma
in the baby's room.
Yeah.
Thank you.
When Lulu was born, I think that was one of the best moments. But I think it was just where the whole family just kind of felt incredibly connected. One of the main things is just seeing how his parents are always there for each other no matter what the circumstances are.
I was really naive back then. I didn't know much about anything. But the one thing that I thought I knew for sure was that you would never, ever hurt me. I had no idea that I could be so brutal. How could you do that to me? How could you say that you loved me and call me your angel and then rape me?
You can definitely survive. It has to do with each character's choice. Whether they want to let down their pride, their mistakes, you know, and just kind of say, you know, this is worth it to get through this. The fame and the love and the life that we've had up to this point is worth fighting for.
And Scotty and the police kept asking me, who did this to you? I wanted to say I did it.
Oh, Mark, come on.
I don't blame myself anymore. And you know why? Because you didn't. You didn't really want to have a right to. At that moment that I realized maybe this didn't have to ruin everyone's lives. It felt like forgiveness to me. And that felt like something that I could give back to you.
Once you open yourself up to that point, there's no other way to go than to work through things. Because you're not going to live. A part of you is going to die if this relationship doesn't last. I think that's what's kept him going.
For God's sakes, Luke, it has been 20 years.
But very nervous because just don't know what's going to happen. I want it to be accurate and I really want to know it.
Erica Kane is the daytime diva of the world. She is. She's Erica Kane is soap opera.
It's very hard to think of the most outrageous thing that Erica Kane has ever done in the name of love.
You get out of my way. I'm getting back in the way.
Erica, what is going on? Where is Travis?
Travis couldn't make it in time, so I have to reset him.
I have to stay with you.
Guys, just stay or die. My life will be over. You need your comfort to be more comfortable. You can't always count.
Definitely, Erica wants to have it all, and she wants to have it all right now, everything. Erica is an incurable romantic. I think central to Erica's life is to be loved and to love. When Erica says, I do, she means it at the time, till death do us part.
Wow, Erica Kane's full name. Erica Kane, Montgomery, Mark, Montgomery.
Who else was it?
I think it was about 8 or 9. Is she up to 9 now?
Oh my God, Adam Chandler. How could I forget Adam?
Well, you can name some of them. Who was she?
Adam Chandler, Nick.
Some of these marriages weren't legal, but it's Erica Kane, Martin Brent, Cudahy Chamber, Roy Roy, Montgomery Montgomery, Merrick Merrick. That's, I think that's it.